Leopard 2 is the logical successor to the Leo 1, with a larger 120mm gun and Chobham-style armor. It evolved from talks with America in the 1970s aimed at jointly producing a new NATO tank. But these eventually foundered, so the Germans went ahead with their own design. The Rheinmetall 120mm smoothbore gun developed for the Leopard 2 is extremely accurate. It can kill enemy tanks at ranges up to 4,000 yards by day or night. The gun, which is also fitted in the American M1A1, fires fin-stabilized ammunition. Two types of anti-tank rounds are available, APDS and HEAT, or high explosive anti-tank. The cartridge cases are semi-combustible to reduce clutter in the fighting compartment. The gun sights are fully stabilized. On the left, an unstabilized view. On the right, the gunner's view. A thermal image intensifier picks up the infrared signature of a target vehicle so the gunner can lock on under all weather conditions in daylight or darkness. If there is a failure in the main integrated firing system, the gunner has an auxiliary sight. A panoramic periscope in the turret roof gives the commander all-round vision. He can also override the gunner and can himself lock onto and engage a target. The integrated fire control computer automatically processes all necessary data. This includes range, type of ammunition selected, cant angle of own vehicle, movement of target, and movement of own vehicle. The gun can fire with equal accuracy whether the tank is moving or stationary. Auxiliary armament includes a coaxial 7.62mm machine gun for use against enemy infantry. There is also an anti-aircraft machine gun on the turret roof. For protection against both solid armor-piercing and hollow charge rounds, Leopard 2's upper hull and turret feature the layered ceramic armor developed by the British Fighting Vehicle Research and Development Establishment at Chobham. The tank's floor plates are specially shaped to diminish the effect of mine explosions. Leopard 2's exceptional mobility is generated by its 1,500 horsepower turbocharged diesel engine, which gives the 55-ton vehicle an exceptionally high power-to-weight ratio. Turret-mounted smoke grenade dischargers allow it to escape if attacked in an unfavorable position. Filters to protect the crew from nuclear, biological, and chemical contamination can be changed from outside the tank. Leopard 2 is thus a very elusive target to hit and difficult to destroy, while itself being able to deliver devastating firepower. For speed, it can accelerate from a standing start to 32 kilometers or 20 miles per hour in only 6 seconds. Leo 1 has a top speed of 72 kilometers or 45 miles per hour. Braking distance from top speed is only 35 meters or 38 yards. Essentially, the lower hull and running gear are virtually unchanged from the Leopard 1. The hydropneumatic suspension gives infinitely variable steering. The tank can turn on its own axis in a mere 5 seconds. Leopard 2 can easily cross a 10-foot trench. It can also climb anti-tank obstacles over 3 feet high. Even sets of road obstacles do not interrupt the smooth ride. Like the Leopard 1, Leo 2 can be quickly fitted with deep wading equipment, allowing it to cross rivers up to 13 feet deep. The commander directs the driver from his conning tower while the vehicle is submerged. The driver has exceptionally good visibility through wide vision blocks. Ease of maintenance is a major feature of both Leo 1 and 2. With the help of a Bergepanzer's crane, the entire engine pack can be changed in the field in only 15 minutes. With some 1,800 tanks in German Army service alone, and others built for Belgium and in Switzerland, Leopard 2 is one of the most important vehicles in the NATO armory. Its exceptional firepower, mobility, and cross-country performance will certainly enable it to give a good account of itself if ever called upon to do so.